What's up, internet? I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com, and today's video is about how to install Oracle Database 12c on Windows 7 64-bit. Unfortunately, Oracle Database 12c is not yet available for 32-bit Windows environment. Also, if we talk about Windows environment, then Oracle Database 12c only supports Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows Server 2008, Windows Server 2008 R2, and Windows Server 2012. You can follow the same step for the installation on either of these versions. Plus, it's highly recommended to have at least 2 GB of main memory and 10 GB of free disk space along with the updated version of JDK, which you can freely download from the Oracle website. Before starting, let me tell you first that I am going to install Oracle Database 12c on Windows 7 Professional 64-bit machine. The same step can be followed for the version that I mentioned just now. So let's start. First, we need to download the Oracle Database 12c setup file. For that, head over to www.oracle.com. Here on this website, hover your cursor over this download menu and then choose this Oracle Database link under this database section. Doing so will take you to the Oracle Database download page. On this page, you have to accept the OTN license agreement. After that, come to this Oracle Database 12c Release 1 section. Here, as you can see, we have two versions of Oracle 12c, namely the Enterprise Edition and the Standard, Standard 1 and Enterprise Edition. You can download either of them according to your need. I will download this second version, which is a Standard, Standard 1 and Enterprise Edition. And as I'm going to install the Oracle Database 12c on Windows 7 64-bit, thus I will go with the first link. Now, we have to download these two files. You can either download them directly from here or you can click the See All link. I will go with the later option. After clicking the See All link, you will be on this Oracle Database 12c R1 download web page. Here, again, first accept the OTN license agreement and then download these two files. To start the download, you need to sign in on Oracle website. For that, you need to have a valid account here. If you have any, then just fill the username and password and hit the sign in button. This will start the download. Otherwise, you can create an account for free. Just to save the time, I have already downloaded both the files. Now, I will make a folder by the name of Oracle 12c and then I will move these freshly downloaded files in that folder. Okay, done. Let's go to this folder. Now, as you can see, both the files are compressed as JIPs, so first we need to uncompress them and extract the content of these files. First, I will uncompress our first folder. It's done. Now, I will rename it from database to database 1. Again, I will uncompress and extract the content of second folder. Here we are now, and I will rename this one from database to database 2. Now, we have to go to the directory database 2. And then go to this folder stage and then components. Here you have to copy all these 5 folders. After doing so, come to our base directory, which is Oracle 12c. Now here, this time open the directory database 1 and then stage and then components, and here paste those 5 folders which we copied from database 2 directory. With this, we are done with all the pre-installation process of Oracle Database 12c and we are all set to start the installation. So come to directory database 1. And here, right-click the setup.exe file and choose Run as Administrator. This will start the OUI. Step 1. Configure security updates. If you wish to have all the security notification on your email, then you can provide your email address here, otherwise hit Next. Avoid this warning, it's just saying that you haven't provided the email address. Hit Yes and move ahead. Step 2. Software updates. If you have Oracle support credentials, then fill here and download the updates. Or if you already have downloaded the updates, then choose the second option. Since in our case, we just downloaded the fresh and updated version of Oracle 12c, hence just select the skip update option and hit next. Step 3. Installation option. Here we have 3 options. Create and configure a database, install database software only, or upgrade an existing database. If you already have a database and want to upgrade that with Oracle Database 12c, then go with the third option. Or if you just want to install the Oracle software and don't want to create any database, then go with the second option. Otherwise, if you want to create and configure database along with installing all database software, then choose first option as I am going to do here. So I am going to select the first option, which is already selected. Now hit next and move to the next step. Step 4. System class. Here you have 2 options, desktop class and server class. See, if your system is capable for handling the load of server class services, then go with the server class. Or if you are installing Oracle Database 12c on your desktop or laptop, then go with the desktop class. I will choose the desktop class, which is already selected. Now hit next and move ahead. Step 5. Oracle Home User Selection. Till the now, the installation was pretty similar to that of Oracle 11g or 10g. But here we have a different step. Now with Oracle Database 12c, you can create an Oracle Home user at the time of installation. This user will be responsible for running all Oracle Home Windows services. Note that this user is associated with an Oracle Home and cannot be chained to a different user after the installation. Here we have 3 options. With the first option, you can use any existing Windows user, but this user must be a standard Windows user or say limited Windows user and not the administrative one. If you choose the second option, then Oracle will create a new standard Windows user for you and then will assign this user as an Oracle Home user. And if you will choose the third option, then Oracle OUI will use Windows built-in account as an Oracle Home user. Here I will choose the second option and will create a new limited or say standard user for my Oracle Home. I will name my user as Rebellion Rider. You can give whatever name you want, and I will set the password as Oracle. Make sure to note down this information somewhere safely because it will be required later for administer or manage database services. Now, hit next and move ahead. Step 6, typical installation. This window will show you all the important configuration settings of your Oracle Database 12c, such as Oracle Base, that indicates the location of base directory for your Oracle software, which will serve as the top level directory. Next, we have software location, which is very well known by the name of DB Home directory. This directory will indicate the location where you can find all the binaries of your Oracle database. Next is database file location. This field can be used to set the location where all the important files like control files, data files, and redo logs will be saved by Oracle. Next, we have database edition. Here you can choose what edition of Oracle Database 12c you want to install. I will let it be on the default one, which is Enterprise Edition. Next is character set. Using this option, you can tell your database which method do you want it to use for saving the character data into the database. You have two options. You can choose either of them. I will leave it on the default. Then we have global database name. Using this field, you can set the global name for your database. This will also serve as the SID of your database. Let it be on ORCL. You can give any name of your choice here. In the next two field, you have to set the administrative password. This password will be used as the password for privileged users such as sys and system. For this demonstration, I will set my password as Oracle only. Make sure to note down global database name and password safely. Next, we have a checkbox saying create as container database. Let it be checked. This option will create a database as container database that can support maximum up to 252 pluggable database. Next is a pluggable database name. Here you have to specify a unique name for your pluggable database. For this demonstration, I will let it be on the default one, which is PDB-ORCL. But if you want, you can change it. Before moving ahead, I just want to make a small change in the directory path. I just want to add Oracle DB12c directory here as a base directory. It's just to make directory structure more specific in the system. It's purely an individual choice. If you want to change it, then it's okay. Otherwise, let it be on the default one. Okay then, click next and move ahead. Avoid this warning. It says that the password which I have given is not according to the Oracle standard. Just hit yes and move ahead. Next window will check for the entire necessary prerequisites for Oracle Database 12c installation. If there is an error, it will show you here. But fortunately, we don't have any error and we are good to go. Next, just hit the install button. This will start the installation of Oracle Database 12c. Just to save the time, I am fast forwarding this process. Here is our DBCA window. This utility will create and configure the database on your system. This process is also time taking, so again I am fast forwarding it. Okay, password management. Here on this window of DBCA, you can configure and unlock the sample account if you want. You can click this password management button, which will open a password management window for you. Here, just select the account which you want to unlock and then uncheck the corresponding column to that account and provide the password. For example, let's say I want to unlock the anonymous account. For that, first I will uncheck this column and then I will write my password here in this new password column. And then enter the same in the confirm password column. Then just hit OK. Avoid this warning. This warning is just saying that the password which we just enter is not up to the Oracle password standard. Just hit yes and move ahead. Okay, we are back on our DBCA window. Here, as you can see, we have all the necessary configuration displayed, such as global name of the database, SID of the database, and the URL of Enterprise Manager. I would suggest you to save this URL. Here, just hit OK. Your installation is successful. You are free to close this window. For that, just click this close button. Hope this video will help you in installing Oracle Database 12c on your system. That's it for today. Please hit the thumbs up button if you like this video. You can also comment and share this tutorial with all your friends on your social networking. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. We'll see you soon. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.